Welcome to Holy Apostles on this All Saints Sunday, November the 1st. Wherever you may be, we're glad that you're worshiping with us today. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one. Holy God, holy and mighty, holy immortal one. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, you've knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns one God in glory everlasting. Amen.
A reading from the Revelation to John. After this I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun shall not strike them, nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As our response, let us say Psalm 34 responsively. I'll read to the star, and then you follow. I will bless the Lord at all times.
His praise shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord.
Let
proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. I sought the Lord, and he answered me. Look upon him and be radiant. I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me. The angel of the Lord encompasses those who fear him. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Fear the Lord, that you that are his saints. The young lions lack and suffer hunger. The Lord ransoms the life of his servants. A reading from the first letter of John. See what the love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up to the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive joy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called the children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Father, make us the masters of ourselves that we might become the servants of others. Take our minds and think with them. Take our lips and speak with them. Take our hearts and set them on fire. Amen. Please be seated. Today, November the 1st, the church celebrates All Saints' Day. It's the time we set aside to remember the lives of those who serve the church in special ways. They have been sainted in the formal process of the church. That is, their lives have been sacred, set aside for special use by us as guides for our faith. Over the past several years, during the month of October, Holy Apostles has explored the lives of the saints as a lead-in to the celebration of All Saints' Day. This year, in Sunday Adult Formation, we focused on the lives of the apostles, the first and original saints. It has been fascinating to find out more about the actual lives of each of these individuals and not simply the best parts or the somewhat sanitized versions of their lives that we learned in childhood. This has given us the opportunity to learn the varied, unexpected, and more interesting view of the real-life humans that we have given the title saint, with an uppercase S. But did you know that All Saints' Day is only one part of our church celebration that's known as All Hallows' Tide? And no, it has nothing to do with college football. All Hallows' Tide is a period of 2 days in our church year that we set aside to remember all of the saints. November 1st is for the capital S saints, and November the 2nd is designated for the lowercase s saints, the ordinary folk we know and love who have died in the past year. We call this day All Souls' Day. But as Billy Mays said, wait, there's more. Not only are there lowercase s saints who have died and gone before us, there are saints living right now among us. And guess what? It's you. I speak a truth. Yes, you. You are a saint. If I know each of you as well as I think I do, you're now giving me the hairy eyeball and thinking that she has no idea what she's saying. What, me? A saint? No way. But you are. It says so in our scriptures and in the creeds. In at least 4 different New Testament scriptures, the followers of Jesus are described as saints. Each week in the creed, we say that we believe in the communion of saints, the followers of Jesus, both living and dead. This is the great cloud of witnesses that we hear so much about. So how am I so certain that you are saints? Well, a good look at the gospel reading today may help with that. This reading in Matthew occurs very early in Jesus' ministry when he sits down on the hill and begins to teach the large crowd of ordinary, small town, poor, and mostly uneducated Jews. He begins by teaching what we know as the Beatitudes. Now, most of us have heard these as instructions on how to be good and be a good enough Christian to get into heaven, or at least been given the impression that that's what they're meant to say. We've heard this reading of the Beatitudes so many times, and perhaps some of you memorized it in your youth. It's become so ordinary that it may seem rote. Well, I want to admit to you that I have struggled with some of this reading for a long, long time. It has always been difficult for me to accept that I could not live up to all that it seems to be requiring of me. Maybe I'm not alone. So I searched for understanding. Now, first, it's important to remember that first century Jewish people did not spend much energy or thought on the afterlife. And Jesus was a devoted Jew. They were not particularly focused on making their way to a place called heaven. This was merely a side conversation for their scholars. So it's unlikely that when Jesus taught the Beatitudes that he was focusing on teaching people how to get to heaven. So I wanted to find out more about what Jesus might be talking to them about, so I looked up the main word, blessed. It means happy. And this is the way it's translated in the Jerusalem Bible that I often use. Happy are the poor in spirit. Happy are the gentle, or you might substitute bullied. Happy are those who mourn. Now wait just a minute here, this does not sound right at all to me. Am I required to be happy when I have doubts in faith, when I'm bullied, or when someone I love dies? I needed to figure this out. I did more searching and found that the meaning of blessed isn't simply happy. It's greatly happy. This was not helpful. So I looked further to find out that this is the kind of happy that comes from having gratitude. So let's try substituting the word grateful and see what happens. Grateful are the poor. Grateful are the meek. Grateful are those who mourn. This didn't seem any better. And I didn't seem to be getting anywhere with this line of inquiry. So I asked one of my friends what she thought. She's currently in a class studying the New Testament with Amy Jill Levine, a foremost authority on the New Testament and a practicing Jew. In the class, Levine explained one of the Beatitudes something like this. In first century Israel, not everyone was able to mourn. And it was considered a great benefit, a privilege, to be able to grieve and mourn. To mourn at that time meant that you were surrounded by your friends and faith community, and they would sit Shiva with you. In the Jewish tradition, after the initial period of despair, lamentation, and burial, friends will sit Shiva with those who mourn. And to sit Shiva means to be with those who mourn for 7 days, to embrace the time of loss, to make time to discuss the life of the one who is gone, and to comfort one another in this mutual loss. The people Jesus was addressing had to work every day just to have enough to eat. Most of them did not have this privilege. Now, sitting Shiva is not what we do, but our traditions are also so important in our process of grieving. It helps us to care for those who mourn and to value the life that's no longer among us. It changes the Beatitudes to realize how the people would have heard this. They knew it was a privilege to be able to mourn. They didn't have that luxury. Jesus is teaching about gratitude and how to use it. He's explaining that they are to notice those who are denied this compassion and freely offer this care to those in need. Now, to protect our health and safety during our time of pandemic, the opportunity to mourn has become nearly absent. As a worshiping community that in unusual times acknowledges loss and provides gracious times of mourning, this is very difficult for us. We're becoming more aware of the need to offer compassion to those who are mourning. And when we find ways to do that, those in grief see a saint. When we have suffered the pain of harsh treatment and are gentle with someone who is harsh to us or who has received and suffered from harshness, that person sees a saint. When you're honest about your moments of weakness and faith and rely on others to hold you up, it gives permission to others to do the same, and they see a saint in you. When you stand up for what is just, what respects the dignity of others, because your dignity was denied to you, the world sees a saint. When you have been hurt and you forgive, that is, when you are merciful, those around you see a saint. When you see that God first views everyone as good and you can accept and love yourself, that is, when you are pure in heart, then you're able to see the face of God in others. And the folks around you see a saint. When you help folks with differing views or understandings learn to respect one another and care for one another despite those differences, when you are a peacemaker, they and others see a saint. And when, because you do these things, you are isolated, mistreated, distrusted, hated, or perhaps even killed, God knows that at your deepest core of being, you are His beloved child. Jesus is telling the first century Jews and us today how He sees the saint in each one of us. The Beatitudes are not about striving to be some ideal for the purpose of gaining heaven. What Jesus is teaching is that when we, purely out of gratitude, freely give back to those we notice are in need, the very blessing that we ourselves have received, people see the saint in us. This is how we shine our light. The Beatitudes are there to help us see the needs of others and the saint in ourselves. As I watch how you live, the people who call holy apostles their spiritual home, I see saints who walk this earth today.
Please stand as we affirm our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, He became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, He rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are according to Form 6. In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work, for this community, the nation, and the world,
for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace,
for the just and proper use of your creation,
for the victims of hunger, freedom, justice, and oppression,
for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble,
for those who minister to the sick, the friends, and the needy,
for the peace and unity of the Church of God, for Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Key and Glenda, our bishops, Blake, our rector, Emily, our curate, Marty, our deacon, Jose, our seminarian, and for all bishops and other ministers. For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, for Bill, Carlisle, Clara, Dolores, Leah, Matthew, Paige, Pimmy, Raymond, Sandra, Savannah, Theodore, Vanessa, and Tracy. For those affected by the recent wildfires and hurricanes, we pray for the victims of violence and for peace and understanding in the world. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we remember the Church of the Province of West Africa. We pray for our companion diocese in the Virgin Islands and its Bishop Ambrose, All Saints Aliceville, All Saints Birmingham, All Saints Montgomery, River Chates Baptist Church, and for all who seek to be faithful to the call of Jesus Christ. Hear us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. We exalt you, O God, our King. On this All Saints Sunday, we pray for those buried from Holy Apostles, Maggie Taylor, Dot Cook, Ron Knapp, Bruce Clace, and Sandra Brown. And we pray for those who have died, especially Bill Hickman, Paul Moore, Denny Paul Ratliff, and for those we now name, that they may have peace in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Please be seated. Welcome once again to Holy Apostles on this All Saints Sunday. We're glad you're here worshiping with us. There are a few announcements for us today. Recently, our Return to Worship transition team sent out a link to another worship survey. You may remember back in the summer months, we sent out a link to an earlier survey. And so we felt this was the right time for a second worship survey. And so we invite you to go online and pull up that link, go to our church Facebook page for the link or our Wednesday happenings and participate. We want to hear from you and want you to be part of our worship survey. Coming up in November, we have some exciting things on our church calendar this month. The first is Saturday, November 14th. Our new curate, Emily Collette, will be ordained to the priesthood at 11 o'clock here on the 14th. Bishop Keith Sloan will be here for the ordination. It'll be a big day in the life of our church and a big day for her as well. The service that day will be for her family, her friends, her loved ones. Here, we feel that that a group of that size we could safely accommodate with social distancing here in our sanctuary. And then after the ordination service, there's going to be a big reception for her when our Holy Apostles community will be invited. And so we hope that you will come about 12 o'clock, 12:15, 12:30 after the service. Come for the stand-up reception. It'll be outside in our church parking lot. We're going to offer a boxed lunch that day. Go online to and be looking for the link to on Sign Up Genius, and please register for a lunch that day. We'd love to feed you, we'd love to see you, and have you celebrate with Emily on the 14th. And then on Sunday, November the 22nd, Bishop Glenda Curry will be here. She'll be offering confirmation, reception, and reaffirmation of faith. And so we invite you to think and pray about this in your life. If you would like to be confirmed, if you'd like to be received into the Episcopal Church or reaffirm your faith, her visit would be an opportunity to do that. So think about that and pray about that in your life. And please contact one of our clergy and let us know if you'd be interested. And finally, this morning, it's stewardship season here at Holy Apostles. Many have already started to turn in your pledges, and we are grateful for your financial gifts. If you haven't yet turned in your pledge, please take a minute, fill out your pledge form. If you need a pledge form, contact the church office or go online on our church Facebook page. We come now to our offertory. We are grateful for your financial gifts and contributions which support our ministries here at Holy Apostles. Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to the Lord. Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you this day, be in your home, and remain with you always. Amen.
And now let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
And the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.